Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to another color grading tutorial, and today we're going to be working with the Sony FS7 S-Log2 footage provided by Marco Fenton. I hope I pronounced your name correctly, Marco. If I didn't, I'm sorry. And this is actually going to be a multi-step tutorial. We're going to do a few episodes about it. I'm going to teach you guys how to duplicate the shots. Basically, how to match the shots with the different camera angles, along with obviously the color grading that we're gonna do right now. So it's gonna be a lot of cool things that I haven't covered in my previous tutorials. As well, I'm actually gonna talk a little bit about a color theory. So let's get started. We're gonna be working on this clip in today's tutorial, okay? I'm gonna make the window a little bit bigger, and we have a shot over here that's been shot on S-Log2, Sony FS7 camera. And the first thing that I'm going to do is I need to decide where do I want to take this. What kind of approach I want to do it as the colorist. Well, I kind of have a few options because it's such a perfectly lit shot. You know, we have the perfect, a little bit hazy background. We have perfect lighting on the main characters, and even if I'm gonna go right now and I'm gonna apply the false color plugin, we can see even by default we actually have a very, very good exposure. So where I'm gonna take this, well, for the beginning, let's figure out what we're gonna do. And I think I'm gonna give it a little bit kind of I guess X-Files look, even though I haven't, you know, watched X-Files in a long time. But let's see what we can do. Okay, let me zoom in and let's take a look at our noise level. And I can tell that the noise level is actually very, very minimal. This is realistically a perfect shot. We barely have any noise. I don't know if you guys can see this or not. Zoomed in, what, like almost 600%, we kind of see a little bit dancing noise, but realistically nobody gonna be zooming in that close anyways. So let me do the first thing, and the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna be grading it with the LUT, with my favorite, okay, what happened there, I didn't select it, with my favorite 2383 LUT. Okay, I'm gonna call this LUT just like that. And over here, I have an option either to leave it alone for future or to work on it right now. But for now, I'm going to leave it alone. I'm going to come back to it. I'm going to create a new node and I'm going to call this exposure. Okay, and if we're going to take a look at the scopes, we can see that our blacks crashed really, really strongly. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to lift it a little bit. Okay, I don't want to be crashing any blacks. And you guys can see, as I'm lifting, look around 60 area. You can see how it compresses if I'm bringing it down. So I kind of want to have a little bit of information on blacks. So I don't want to crash it completely. And I'm going to bring the highlights down. And there's a very interesting thing, actually, when you're working with the LUT. Everything that happens before LUT, you almost like having some kind of a pivot. So when you do your adjustments, you get very interesting, the reaction. If you're going to do the same adjustments after the LUT, you're going to have completely different result. For example, we actually can go below the zero. But if we're going to do this before the LUT, we're sort of clipping right above. So very interesting. You know, keep that in mind when you do color grading, whatever adjustments you're making. That way you're kind of aware what exactly is going on. Okay, so I'm going to create a new node, and I'm going to drop the false colors over here just for visual reference for you guys. As of right now, I really like where everything is standing. Okay, let me turn it off. So let's see, before, after. Okay, we start giving it a little bit of look. Now I'm going to create another node. And in this node, I'm going to call this saturation. All right, just SAT. Just like that. And I'm going to increase saturation individually, like I do it in all of my previous tutorials. And I think it's a little bit saturated if we're going to go to the Vectorscope. Let's see. I think it's a little bit saturated. It's a little bit warm for my taste. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to dial it down in a key output by half. That way, I'm only giving a little bit of punch. Okay. So we have our basic sort of grading, the basic beginning done. Now, what we're going to do? Well, I'm actually thinking to give it a very interesting stylized look. And how I'm going to do this, I'm going to create a new node. Actually, I'm going to do a couple steps. Just to be safe, what I want to do a first color balance. I want to make sure that everything is balanced more or less properly before I'm going to continue. So I'm going to go to the temperature, and I'm going to do sort of very basic color balance. Let me go back to the parade really quick. Let's see. A little bit warm. Okay, let's check it out before and after. Okay, so this is relatively neutral color balance. I'm going to call it balance. And this is really, I guess you can call it a dummy node. I just want to make sure that before I'm going to be doing any kind of creative looks, I have sort of a reference point that I can always link to this balance node in case I need to get a skin details or something like that. Okay, and in the next node, I'm going to call this temperature, and also the temperature going to be my look at the same time. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to dial it down just like this. I want the shot to be very cold. Okay, perfect. I really like it. We almost there. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to select all of them. I'm going to right click and I'm going to create compound node. Okay, that way they're not on our way of color grading. So I'm going to create another node just like this. And I'm going to convert it into parallel mixer. So now we're going to start polishing our shot a little bit more. Okay, so we have that interesting side shot. Let me turn on again false colors. And as we can see, nothing really changed. I really like where the exposure is. Also, I really like how her nursing, I guess, dress or whatever you want to call this is white comparing to before. It was slightly a little bit yellowish. Okay, so we're keeping the colors pretty accurate. Okay, and now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a first node, and I'm going to call this general light. Okay, and in this general light, I'm actually going to take a look at this entire clip. Okay, and I can see that it's been lit sort of from behind a little bit. And I'm actually going to replicate that. And how I'm going to do this? Well, very simple. I'm going to go to the custom curves. And I sort of going to do a very sloppy mask like this. Okay? I'm going to give it a bit of a mid-tones, a healthy amount of mid-tones. Let's make sure that we're going to soften a little bit. It's not going to be very hard edges. And now I'm going to go to the qualifier. Okay, I want to make sure that we're only going to be affecting the bright stuff. Actually, I did it the other way. Sorry. Okay. I guess like this is fine. And we're going to feather it a little bit. Okay. And a little bit clean white. Just to make sure that our key is a little bit cleaner. Okay. And let's take a look. So I'm doing the wrong note before and after. So this thing is very visible, obviously, right now. But what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to soften it even more. And I'm going to give it a little bit of extra contrast. Okay, just like that. So basically what I want to do, I want to make sure that everything blends seamlessly. That way we don't have any kind of weird, you know, lines or anything like that going on. So let's check it out. Before and after. Before and after. Huge difference. Huge, huge difference. Love it. Okay, so that's number one. Number two. Let's gonna call this one light number two. Light number two. Oops. 23. Just two. All right. And for this one, I'm gonna do, I guess, a very basic in a way. Kind of like this. Okay, let's give it a nice feather. I want to make it pretty big. Very large source with lots of feathering. And basically with this, I want to give it a little bit kind of a glow, just like this. Okay? And possibly I can give it a little color match too. Okay, so check it out. Before and after. Before and after. Okay, let me turn off that false color. And let's take a look what we have going on so far. Okay, so that's before and after. And as you guys can see, we're actually preserving a very healthy skin information. So let me create a new node. And this one I'm going to be calling contrast. Okay, this one is going to be very straightforward. I'm not even going to use curves. All I'm going to do, just give it a nice little contrast pop. And I want to make sure also, and I'm probably going to do it with a curve, that I'm not clipping any blacks. Okay, that's not the best way of doing this. Okay, I want to make sure that I'm not clipping any blacks. Okay, so let's keep it like this. Let's check it out. Before and after. Before and after. You know, a little bit of extra touch looks really good. Okay, so we have this going on. What else can we do? Well, let's take a look at the Vectorscope, what we have going on. So basically at this moment, we sort of have very classic, I guess you want to call it teal and orange split, but we can take it to the next level. So let's create another node, and we're going to call this one look. And we can either finesse what we have, or we can create a slightly little bit different. So I'm going to go into primary bars and I'm going to turn off Luma Mix. And I'm just going to be playing with the midtones, primarily with the green and blue. So let me give it a little touch of green, and let me just play a little bit with the blue. Okay. I like it. Let's check it out. Before and after. Before and after. So we sort of gave her a little bit of more green. I think visually that looks a little bit more interesting rather than having just a classic clean look. And if you pay attention, look how a little bit of very slight adjustments actually makes visually a huge difference. A lot of times when people color grade, they immediately thinking that if you're working as a colorist, you need to do, you know, absolutely something ridiculous and completely changed how everything looks. But basically as a colorist, and especially if you have really good footage like this one, for example, you really don't need to do much in terms of manipulating colors. So keep that in mind. Okay, so we have this going on. Let me go outside. All right, let's take a look. Obviously our compound was a very basic adjustment, but at the same time, we pretty much did half of the job there. Relighting, look at that huge difference right over here. Light number two, we added a little bit more depth like that. Basically, I love working with the lights. Whenever you build the lights, you're creating a lot of depth. You're making a simple shot more 3D dimensional. And if we're going to go back, you can see how it sort of look a little bit flat, even though the lighting is absolutely perfect. But digitally, we can actually enhance that. Now, we added a little bit of contrast, okay? And then we added a little bit of look. Okay, so everything looks great to my taste. And if we're gonna go back to parade, the only thing I want to make sure that our black is staining black. So I'm gonna go to Luma versus saturation, and I'm gonna do my favorite curve. Basically, I'm going to desaturate a little bit. Okay, let's see. Let's do it. Let's see, just like that. Okay, perfect. It does the job slightly, but it does the job if you can take a look over here at the scopes. Okay, we're basically protecting the shadow. We want to make sure that very, very black is staining black. We don't want to have a weird, color stuff like a lot of amateur colorists do, for example, something like this when people, color grade like that and they calling it a day. This is, looks pretty ridiculous. Okay, let's play it back. It looks very, very nice. I really like it. The only thing I probably want to do is give a little bit of midtones details. Let's give it a little midtones pop and let's take a look if we actually can see. Okay, I don't know if the YouTube allows you to see it, but we're definitely getting a little bit more details in the guy's cars. Now, the one thing, and probably, I guess it would be a little bit amateur for me to do, not everything always needs to be visible. A lot of people, for example, I know 100% what a lot of people would do, color grading, and I sort of addressed this kind of problem in the previous tutorials, but a lot of people would probably try to have the mask like this on the guy, and they would think like, oh, okay, we want to make sure that we see the guy, so they would do something ridiculous like that, and you don't always have to do this. If there would be a director's decision to have this guy completely 100% visible, he would be lit that way. You always, when you color grade, you always need to look at the actual lighting on set. Don't try to change completely entire game thinking as a colorist this is, exactly what you have to do. If we look at the lighting is very dramatic. It's falling from the side. We can enhance that. But as a colorist, you don't have to be changing it 100% completely. So always keep that in mind. Okay, so let's take a look again, before and after. Let me come over here and let's take a look again, before and after. Let's see. Let's play it back. And I think it looks great. It looks very nice. It looks very cinematic. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in a couple days. Take care.